Good afternoon.
Thank you very much, Katie, for the kind introduction and for the organizers for inviting me and for the opportunity to speak about the latest measures we have initiated in Germany to sustain acceptance and improve vaccination coverage. Just a few facts about the German healthcare system in order to understand why we do some things and why we don't. So Germany is the largest country by population in the European Union with about 82 million inhabitants. Germany is a federal republic with 16 Länder divided into 402 counties, and the population of the states vary from 600,000 to 18 million. And considerable freedom of action and responsibilities are given to the Länder under German law, and this includes the healthcare sector. There is a sharing of decision-making powers between Länder and federal government, and the Länder are responsible for most aspects of healthcare and health protection. And we have all in all a highly decentralized healthcare system, and these heterogeneous responsibilities sometimes impede a consistent national vaccination policy. 90% of vaccines in Germany are given by private physicians in their medical practices, and these private physicians play the key role in our immunization systems. And our protection against infection law that is responsible for managing all infectious diseases from 2000 advocates immunization and defines it as a public health task. All recommended vaccines are free of charge and they paid by the health insurances. And everybody in Germany has a health insurance. And we have a standing committee on vaccination, our NITEC, since 1972, and they make the recommendations for vaccinations. And these recommendations are very strong, and the Federal Supreme Court stated that the recommendations of the STIKO are state of the medical knowledge. In West Germany, smallpox vaccination was mandatory till 1982. And in East Germany, the former GDR, all vaccinations were mandatory till reunification. And there was a high acceptance and a high coverage in the GDR, but that was not due to the mandate, but to a very effective organization, because all children went to kindergarten and they were vaccinated in the kindergarten, sometimes also without permission of the parents. So it was very effective and not only due to the mandate. But since 1990, all vaccinations are given on a voluntary basis. Our protection against infection acts still focus on individual responsibility and prevention through education. But in case of an emergency like a pandemic flu, mandatory vaccination is possible by law. And we have no school or daycare requirements regarding immunization. But we have constant debates about mandates in Germany whenever we have an outbreak of measles or another disease. Here you see the headline of a newspaper, a quite liberal newspaper, and one of the best newspapers or magazines we have in Germany, the Zeit, and this states, vaccination leaving the decision to parents is a danger for human life. And you see this comment was commented more than 600 times, so there's a very lively discussion. And only yesterday, the president of the Robert Koch Institute stated that mandates are counterproductive and would increase vaccine hesitancy. So there's a strong debate for pro and con. If you look at the vaccination coverage we have at school entry, it's very high despite of the vaccine coverage against hepatitis B, and here we have, like in France, we reach only 88%, but the coverage for all other vaccines is over 90, often 95%, and for the first M measles-containing vaccines, we reached 96.8%. and for the second 92% aid. There's a slight overestimation because these are only children with vaccination cards. But you see also that for the last 5 years we have a stagnation here in the vaccination coverage, and we have to do a hard job to maintain this high coverage. And I think having a mandate for this least 5%, that would be inappropriate and too much effort to concentrate on this very least 5% who are very hard to reach or get their vaccination. But if you look at other younger ages, not at school entry with 24 months, for the second measles containing vaccine, you see large differences over whole Germany. And it reveals also that the children are vaccinated too late and not as recommended till the second year of life. And we have immunity gaps in adolescents and adults. And this is the greatest group in Germany. And here a mandate would also not be appropriate. Like all countries in the European Union, in the European region of WHO, we committed to measles elimination, and we still have massive problems with reaching this goal. And during this year, we still had 970 cases, and also Romania suffers from it, and also Italy has problems to reach this. And in the whole region, we had this year alone nearly 39 deaths from measles cases. If you look at this data over the last 10 years of the measles cases in Germany, you see that we every second year we had measles outbreak and we never reached the defined goals for measles elimination. Only last year WHO stated that we had transmitted endemic transmission for the last 12 months. This was a little bit progress, but this year we have still higher or more cases than last year. But we faced a new problem this year. There was a measles outbreak in a city called Duisburg. And in this city, there were more than 300 cases. And 70% of these cases were amongst migrants from Romania, Bulgaria, and Turkey, mostly from the Roma and Sinti population. And 90% of the cases were under 1 year. On the national level, it was only 11%, 0.6. And this outbreak doesn't spread to the resident population in Germany because the coverage was very high, 95%. And I don't like the word hard to reach group, but this is really a hard to reach group. But because 80% of them have no health insurance, they don't stay permanently in Germany. They have a very short stay from 1 month, 1 week to 6 months, and they are traveling around, and they have no contact to the health system. So a mandate would also not work in this case to reach these people, because these people could only be reached with the help of firemen and policemen, and the health departments did a hard job to reach them and to finish the outbreak. Like in France and UK, we have also surveys about the attitudes of the general populations regarding vaccine. And here the question was, what is your general attitude towards vaccination? And you see that the very positive is increasing and is even higher in parents. And also that people think it's rather positive is increasing. But contrary to France, we have also a big number of people who say neither positive, neither negative, so are undecided. So we had a lot of people who deny some vaccine, like varicella, but vaccinate their children to all the other recommended vaccines. And if you look at this survey question, they were asked, against which diseases should your child be vaccinated in any case? Top priority has tetanus and polio since the last 6 years, but the priority of measles, rubella, and mumps is increasing. And that's good, because this is also a goal of our national plan, measles elimination plan. But higher educated mothers are less in favor of measles vaccination than others. What are the reasons for the existing immunity gaps in Germany? That's inadequate knowledge of the benefits and the necessity of vaccination, the fear of adverse events, I think it's a universal problem, then fear aroused by vaccine skeptics or anti-vaccination groups. The number is very small in Germany, but they are very loud and sometimes very effective. But a big problem in Germany is that there's an insufficient verification of the immunization status by the physicians and also forgetfulness. We have no established recall system. Our recommended strategies are raising awareness, continued information for the general population, for the education, for the physicians, recall systems, and catch up in schools if possible. We do not have school-based vaccination programs, and of course, political commitment. We have done a lot since the last 5 years. So in 2010, we recommended measles vaccination for susceptible adults born after 1970. And we adopted the National Measles Rubella Action Plan. There was a high political commitment for this plan. All ministers of health adopted this plan, and this plan contains strategic and measurable goals with time frame, responsibilities, and evaluation tools. And the target groups are children aged 11 to 45 months, adolescents, adults, healthcare professionals. They have also a lot of vaccination gaps and those hard to reach groups. 2 years ago, we adopted also the National Preventive Healthcare Act. And this is also, this healthcare act is for strengthening promotion and health promotion and prevention, but it also contains a lot of regulations concerning vaccination. And now, from now on, vaccination monitoring during all medical checkup is introduced for all age groups, not only for children, but also for the adults. A very effective tool is the exclusion of anonymized persons from school and kindergarten during measles outbreaks. The health department did this this year very widely, and a lot of teachers has had to be excluded. We also, company doctors may do more vaccinations, and they are paid for by the health insurances. And the medical facilities may make the recruitment of employees dependent on the existence of the necessary vaccination coverage and immunity. And another regulation is that health insurances can introduce bonus benefits for vaccinations. The most far-reaching regulation is that parents have to present an evidence that they had been counseled by a physician regarding vaccination before they can enter daycare. The rationale behind this regulation is that 90% of parents follow the advice of their physician regarding vaccination. This was stated in many surveys since many years. And in July this year, this paragraph of the act was tightened. If parents do not present the certificate, the kindergarten has to notify the parents to the public health department, and they can invite them for consultation or even put a monetary fine on them up to 2,000 euro. But there's no mandate. Unvaccinated children may still visit a kindergarten. But we know that it works because some lender introduced this regulation before and they had a high increase in vaccination coverage with this certificate. And of course, we make a lot of nationwide campaigns. This is one campaign focusing in young adults, measles also among adults, but we have a lot of other campaigns. What creates trust in vaccines? What we have found out in Germany, that are trustworthy, up-to-date, and transparent information about the safety, necessity, and effectiveness of vaccines, the trust in providers, the positive attitude in social networks, experiences with the disease, and positive experiences with vaccinations. So to sum up, We have no mandatory vaccination in Germany till now, but we have very strong vaccine recommendations by our NITAG. The mandates are discussed regularly, but at the moment they are legally not enforceable. And the focus is now in our politics on the implementation of the regulations of the National Preventive Healthcare Act and the reaching of the national of the goal of vaccine elimination and in the closing of immunity gaps. But I think irrespective of mandatory or voluntary vaccination, we have to increase trust in vaccination. Thank you very much for your attention.